Hello. Oh, I'm Sam. Give me a minute. I'm a principal software engineer with the developer engineering group of Red Hat. And I develop and design microservices applications. And throughout my life, I've been a developer. So yeah, good to be here. And I'm really glad that you turned up for the presentation. So even before we start with our presentation on our development platform that provides you the AI-based application insights, a quick show of hands, how many of you choose dependencies for your applications, if you can? Okay, I think we need to refresh. So let's start with what are dependencies? Dependencies are known in different ecosystems as modules, packages, or libraries. They are reusable code that developers include in for their applications. So it is the libraries or these dependencies that build an application. From these dependencies, developers use functionalities and build their own applications. So they don't write already existing code. But the problem here is that those code are written, or those libraries are developed by someone else who you don't know, who, I don't know, credibility is the right word, but we don't know what we're including. And there is no tool. It's only based on experience and sometimes based on guidance from someone who you know. You include dependencies and you start building your applications. So that's how we do it at this moment. And in our team, when we looked at this area and this domain, we found that this is a big void that we can fill, or we can fill in. So how we started is that we tried to figure out what makes a good dependency. Even for that, developers can't choose at this moment, and this is, again, worsened by the fact that you have these many new packages on new package versions everywhere. You see this exponential growth. That's the NPM. Every day, I think, Jay, it's like 1,000 packages per day, and you have those many choices per day to choose from. So that's insane. And we thought of filling in that void. And when we started with this problem, we figured out that there can be three basic parameters based on which we can decide whether or not we can include dependencies. First one is security vulnerability. If we need to check, basically, this dependency is vulnerable or what, that can be a very good criteria to choose a dependency or not to choose a dependency. Number two can be license. License is tricky. For developers, it does not mean a thing at times. But if your dependencies that you are including have conflicting licenses, say for example, there can be licenses which are permissive, like MIT, Apache, or there can be licenses that are more restrictive, that do not allow your software to, like GPL, it has its own restrictions. So normally what happens when you go and start publishing your, publishing your application, there is a conflict. You can't come up with one license for your own application because you have conflicting license for your dependencies. Then comes the third part, which is popularity and maintainability. Everyone likes to include libraries or include dependencies which are well maintained. So that's a very good criteria, we thought. Fourth one, Jay?
Yeah. So thanks, Sam. So basically, whatever we have seen till now are more like, what are the risks involved when you are setting your dependency for your business patch? Because again, it's a piece of code written by someone else, but you are trusting it more than yourself. But more importantly, there's one more piece, that's the completeness of application stack. Whenever you choose to go with a dependency, the first thing you look for is it doing what it's supposed to do? That's like, what is the value it's going to add to your application stack? That is one important piece which you need to take care of. So as Sam said, we want this space needs some help, and what we are doing as an analytics platform is like enabling developers to choose from wide range of open source dependencies or components out there, so that they can build software with great confidence and thus reduce the associated risk and increase the productivity levels. So let us quickly move to the demo so that we can demonstrate the capability of this platform and how easily it can help you to access or validate your dependencies. One way is you can go through each of your dependencies in your application stack and try to look into different processes and see, okay, it is doing all of those parameters what we spoke about. It doesn't have any security issue, it does good with the licenses, and it is doing what it is intended to do. So for this demonstration purpose, we are using VS Code. So VS Code, all of us know, right? It's one of the popular IDEs these days. I think many of us would be using over here. And it's the home developers.
How many of how many of us are using VS Code here? Sorry. Okay, good. During the course of this demonstration, I think you can go along with us and try to do what we are doing. And we assume that you'll get a report of your application towards the end of the presentation. I highly recommend you doing that. Let's see.
Yeah. So again, VS Code is one of our integrations. So let me quickly go ahead and show you guys. So we are already into marketplace now. You can go to VS Code marketplace and just search for dependency analytics. Obviously, it will show up over there. So the whole purpose of this exercise is to help you guys to understand that with great ease, we are able to provide all the solutions to the developers without much effort. So once you see this particular view, it has a detailed readme where we talked about all the features we support, what are the prerequisites, what are the ecosystems we are supporting as of now.
So currently, we are supporting Maven and NPM as the ecosystem. And obviously, if you are using Maven, you need to have Maven and NPM in your system path. And if you guys don't have VS Code, it's pretty easy to install that as well. You can take a look.
No, we are not recommending you doing that. But means
you can, just in case.
You'd like to try this out, this is a very good option to test our or test your application through our platform.
So to install, it's pretty simple. Just click on install, and you are in the VS Code. And it will ask you to do the install and just follow the steps. It's reload. It's pretty simple to set it up. And we are all good. Once you have installed the extension, it will show up in the extension place as well. You can take a look. I think we are all good with the setup. Now you can open any of your projects of your choice on NPM or Maven, and you can try along with us. So currently, I have opened one of the projects over here just to demonstrate. So if you see over here, we are having some of the dependencies and some of the dev dependencies listed over here. So totally, we have 5 dependencies. And again, we want to perform this exercise to validate how good these dependencies are for the application. So as you can see, the moment package.json is opened, and package.json is nothing but a manifest file where all the dependency information resides for Node ecosystem. So if you can see over here, there are some red markers, blue flat, for bootstrap and moment. So this is trying to show that these dependencies are having security issue associated, along with the CVE IDs. And in the, we also provide the notification, like a scan 5 runtime dependencies, flag 2 potential security vulnerability, along with the quick fixes. So you would have noticed, right? I mean, apart from setting up the extension, nothing much we did, and we are getting all this information without any action associated, just by opening the manifest file. So it happens as and when you type it.
Yeah. So I especially like this part because here is where you open your manifest file. You, as a developer, you're adding your dependency, and you get the information about any vulnerability right there. So it's a very very important information for a developer whether or not he or she is including something that should not be included.
Yeah, and these informations are shown in problems as well. So now let me quickly brief you about all the dependencies we are using and what it does. So if you would have seen ANSI styles, it is used to style strings, basically. Then we have escape string regex, which tries to escape special characters. Then we have support colors, which tries to update user about is this particular terminal supports colors or not. Then we have bootstrap, which is popularly widely used for stylings and UI-based components. And we have moment as well. So moment helps us to parse, validate, manipulate, and display dates in desired format. So this was about the security issue. Now let us quickly try to run the analysis on our whole application and see how, what are other informations or values we're getting from this particular extension and how it makes life of a developer easier. So you can just trigger it, and in the footer you can see we are trying to resolve the dependencies and we'll be taking some actions based on that. So usually what happens, well, we get to know about these problems much later in the development life cycles. Probably, I mean, we filed the PR, it got merged into master, then we realized, you know, the licenses didn't go well, or this particular dependency has a security issue, which may be introduced later, not at that point in time. But we are providing all this flexibility and feature much before when developer is coding the life cycle, basically. So that's the easiest place and to take any action associated. So if you can see over here, we have a detailed stack report being displayed, which provide information about many aspects, what all Sam covered earlier, like talking about security, talking about licenses, be it insights or dependency details. So in the first card, we are talking about security issues. So currently, you can see we have two dependencies which have security. And we saw this in package.json as well. So what extra we are offering here? We are trying to update you along with the CVE IDs associated and the score. CVSS score is nothing but on based on 1 to 10, we rate how critical the issue is. So no matter which color it is showed up, red or orange, I think we should be taking action associated.
Yeah, so these are all reported CVE security vulnerabilities. They have a number associated and they have a score associated. Score determines the severity, how severe that vulnerability is. So that's this is quite intuitive to understand the severity of the vulnerability that you are adding.
Yeah, if you notice over here, we are not just telling that Moment 2.0.0 has a security issue. We're also providing with the recommended version, which will be free of any CVE. And we have other informations as in like current version, GitHub stats, all these are like popularity matrices from the GitHub, which can help you to take an informed decision about what are the number of contributors, how many stars it has got, folks it has, etc. So in next card, we are talking about licenses. So if you can see, based on the dependencies I have used in this particular stack, we are able to suggest MIT as a license. So we are good in this particular scenario, but there won't be case always. Sometimes we will have dependency which don't go along with each other. In that case, we'll be showing you the licenses which are conflicting along with the dependencies where they're conflicting.
So your stack doesn't have any conflicting license like restrictive permissive?
Okay. So next we'll be talking about insights. So this is more about completeness of application stack. So based on the dependencies, whatever being used over here, we'll try to provide you AI-based insights on those dependencies, and we can see, I mean, how good or bad those insights are. So if you notice over here, we are providing 5 dependencies as the insights. So initially I told that we have ANSI colors as one of our dependency, which is used for styling strings. So if you can see, for each of the dependencies, we have a confidence score associated. Like in case of chalk, it goes pretty high, 85%.
So this particular level, a detail show how well we understand your application, and based on our training, the AI training that we have with different types of applications that is available upstream, we try to understand and we try to suggest some dependencies for you, which can go along with your own set of dependencies. So, yeah, and this confidence gives. This is the confidence of the system that this must go or this should go with your dependency, because we have seen it in the other cases.
Yeah, as you can see here, we are giving insights for chalk along with a version like 2.4.2. And chalk is again used for providing colors to strings and all of those things. It does much more than what ANSI colors does usually. And we provide other matrices along with that as well, so that you can take a decision based on all this information. And again, when we say we support like Node and Maven, by no means we are perfect insights. There could be possibility that our recommendations would be very good, or it is not. I mean, you don't like it. So there's always an option to provide a feedback. Yes. We have a thumbs up and thumbs down option.
Yeah, it is a continuous learning for our AI model. So any feedback that you provide, it will be used for retraining the model and giving better recommendations next time.
Yeah, if you can see for other dependencies, the confidence score is not that great. So as Sam said, this feedback helps us to learn and evolve. So that was pretty much about the insights. Let's quickly move to the last section, that is dependency details. So in this, we are trying to analyze all the dependencies in the application. So currently, if you notice, there were 5 dependencies, and in this section, we are showing that total dependencies were 5, and total dependencies analyzed were 5 again. So it is like we are able to analyze all the dependencies, whatever it was in the application stack. But that may not be the case always, because as earlier it was shown, the number of dependencies being added in any ecosystem is like huge. In case of NPM, it goes like 800 to 1,000 downloads plus updates in a day. So there would be a chances that our platform may not be aware of some dependencies, but we have a pipeline in place. Whenever we encounter any unknown dependency, we try to ingest it, so that next time if you try to analyze those things, it will be taken into consideration.
Yep. And this is the popularity and maintainability card, where you get to know a lot of things about these dependencies. We have information about the stargazers count, and also, you can see here the dependent repos. I mean, how many people are using this, and stargazers. How many contributors are contributing to this? So it gives you enough information about what you are using.
Yeah. So that was about the report and all the information we got. It's too much to digest, but it's not just to see. I mean, we need to take some actions associated over here. Like, I'll start with the first one. In case of security issue, we saw 2 dependencies, and we are suggested with the version which will be CVE-free. So quickly, let me go back and make the changes into the package.json. So we'll update moment and bootstrap both to 4.2.1 and 2.22.2. So these were the versions provided in recommendation. So if you'd have noticed, all the red markers has gone. So this dependency doesn't have any security issue associated. Now if we'll try to run a stack analysis again on this particular stack, you would notice that the number of securities are like 0, and nothing changed in any of those cards.
Yeah. So this tells that your application doesn't have any dependency that is vulnerability. So it's vulnerability free at this moment.
So the same applies to the insights as well. You can try adding chalk in your application stack and rerun the analysis and see what is changing in the insights. Yeah. And at the end, I would like to say that we have launched this extension like 3 months back. And this is the first time we are talking about it in any of the conferences. And the number of installs and downloads, as you can see, it's like very good. We have like 11,000 downloads and 5,000 unique installs we have got so far. Yeah. So we'll request you guys to give it a try, provide your feedback, and these are the current use cases, basically. Whatever we saw in the stack report.
Yeah, so I don't think we have to repeat all those things, because we have already seen how security vulnerabilities are shown, and we showed recommended fixes, and about popularity, maintenance, then we showed licenses, and then we also gave insights about the dependencies that you can add, that can be added to your application dependencies.
Yeah, so just to add one point over here, currently you get this information into various sources, but there is no single place where you get all this information at once.
Yeah, so this is the unique report at this moment that we have in the market that gives us this entire landscape of your application. And we believe this is going to be really helpful for developers going forward. And let's now talk about the platform, how we are seeing it going forward. So I see Python developers or Go developers, perhaps here, who might be might be feeling left alone. So we're adding the support for Python and Go very soon. And then comes the transitive dependencies. That's an entirely different area where you don't know what you're adding there. You know about your direct dependencies, but you don't know what are the other dependencies that it pulls. And we are trying to figure out the CV associated with transitive dependencies. We are going to show a mapping between your direct dependency and a transitive dependency that might be lying five layers down, which might have a CV and which can affect your application. So we are planning to do that. And then we are also looking, exploring this container application scanning. In the market at this moment, we have tools that can scan your operating system level vulnerabilities, but not at the application level. So we will be exploring that part. And then we have a very interesting use case when we'll try to figure out any potential security vulnerability in the code. We are not, at this moment, we are actually relying on the reported vulnerabilities. Here we are planning to figure out or try to find out if there are any vulnerability associated through our AI models. And the fifth one is the OCP, OpenShift Container Platform, the service upgrades of those. We are predicting any service failures that can happen. So many of these things are experimental, but this is a roadmap that we have. And yeah, so we are available on GitHub. We are open source. We are Fabricate Analytics. This is the org. And we have a public channel through which you can contact us, this chat.openshift.io. That's where you can go, and you can find us in the public channel, Fabricate Analytics. And thank you very much again for attending. And we are open for questions and answers.
Yeah, thank you, folks.
Thank you.